So I know this is a really random start to the video and it has nothing to do with the topic that we're about to talk about, but look at this. I just put my scarf on my dog. Look how adorable she looks. Maisie. Mwah. So hello and yes, welcome back to another video, guys. So yes, today's video, don't worry, it is Oasis. We're going to be doing Oasis today. I'm going to be showing you my entire Oasis collection. So before we get started, to anyone who's clicked on this video wondering how much Oasis I have, at this point we've just gone into 2018, so I have every studio album from Oasis here on vinyl, including the B-sides compilation, and then going into their solo careers, I have the BDI, the Liam Gallagher, and everything that Noel's put out so far, including a couple of 12 inches. My hair's doing some things at the back there. I apologise. I've been wearing a hat at work today because it's so cold out. It's literally snowing. I'm going to just point the camera this way. You guys can see the floor there. It's white. Hence why there's so many layers on today, guys. So many layers. I've been working outside in the snow. It's freezing. So I'm very pleased to be home in the warm now. And because it's snowing, we also got to come home a tad early, which is nice. Which is why I'm making some videos today. So yes, I say some videos because, quick thing to go over before we get started with the topic at hand, my second channel, the movie channel, I have started uploading videos again on there. I know, again, it's crazy. I keep trying to get that channel going every time, it just never works out anyway. I'm going to push for it because what I'm doing is I'm just doing all the videos for that channel on my phone, so it's very easy, just hit upload straight away and off they go. It's nice and easy, nice and simple. There's a link to my other channel in the description, guys, if you want to check it out. My other channel is pure movies, because movies is actually my biggest passion, movies and TV series, even more than music. And I thought, you know, my main channel here is music. I should really push for this movie one as well, because I love my movies. So a link to my other channel is in the description, guys, if you're interested. Please check it out. Also going to apologise about the noise upstairs, if you can hear it. I've left Parrot Boy Buzz alone, on my new pet parrot, Buzz, so I've just put the radio on for him while I'm not in the room, so I do apologise. But anyway, let's get started. So anyway, none of these are originals, sorry, they are all reissues, I believe. I didn't want to fork out loads of money for originals of these, because I didn't see the point. But anyway, let's get started. So the first album up from Oasis, of course, is definitely Maybe. Which is without a doubt a fantastic album, probably their best album, I'm not going to lie. You know, there's so many good tracks on here, from Rock and Roll Star to Live Forever, to Sad Song, Supersonic, Cigarettes and Alcohol is a personal favourite of mine on here. And it's a really, really solid album. I love the cover as well, really, really awesome. I can't remember whether you get any inner sleeves with this one or not. No, just plain white on this one, so nothing to look at there. But yeah, it's a fantastic album. And I will say this about Oasis' first three albums. The dog's going to cry for food. God, the animals in this house. The first three Oasis albums, I think, should be in everyone's collection, regardless how big of an Oasis fan you are or not. If you're going to get into collecting records and going to be a serious music listener, you have to have the first three Oasis albums. Because this is the all-time classic. What's the story, Morning Glory? I was actually there about a month ago on this exact street doing some record shopping with my good friend Robert. And you can see that in my video called Vlog 4, if you're interested. So yeah, tracks on here. I mean, where do I begin on this album? I mean, Hello, Wonderwall, Don't Look Back in Anger, personal favourite of mine on here. She's Electric, Morning Glory. I mean, there's so many good songs on here. You know, it's a fantastic album. Still hear this album, a lot of songs on this album played about a lot on the radio. Like, you even hear, like, Wonderwall get played in clubs today. I've had that come on in clubs many times. It's still a very, very popular song. And you do get quite a bit with this particular copy of the album. It's triple gatefold, which is nice. Really like that picture. I'm not sure why it's triple gatefold, because there's absolutely nothing in here. I think because it's such a beloved album, they just try to make a really big deal with it. Nina Slaves, they put so much effort into these. I mean, it's ridiculous. Let's see if the other Inner Slave is as pathetic. Whoa, hey, look at that, it is. You know, absolutely fantastic album, man. And again, any serious music listener, you got to have this one in your collection as well. I can't take you seriously if you don't. I'm only kidding. But yeah, it's a fantastic album. I got this one in HMV, as you can see there. So the next album up, of course, is the one and only Be Here Now. Yeah, love this cover. Really cool cover as well. Paying tribute, of course, to Keith Moon, who drove a Rolls Royce into a swimming pool. I'm not sure what the other nods and winks are on here, but I'm sure a lot of the things on here have meanings behind them, and I'm sure people will let me know in the comments, because I know there's bigger experts out there than me, that's for sure, on Oasis. But again, fantastic songs on here as well. My Big Mouth, Stand By Me, Fade Out, Don't Go Away, the title track. Some really, really solid stuff on here, guys. Really, really good album. And I know these ones are plain and white in the sleeve, so I'm not even going to bother taking these ones, this one out to show you. Fantastic record. Fantastic record. Now, I believe this was the next release, or this might have come before Be Here Now. People will have to let me know. This is where the B-Sides album came out, The Master Plan. Which is really nice. I actually love this cover. It looks crap compared to their others, but let me explain to you why I love this cover in a minute. Here's the back. And then, yeah, some really good tracks on here. Going Nowhere is one of my favourites. Fade Away is really good. They do a live cover of The Beatles' I Am The Walrus. Listen Up, that's a good one. But yeah, I'll take the record out and show you why I really like the cover. It's a really clever cover. On the Inner Sleeve, you have close-ups of each character on the cover, and that's the idea, you're supposed to find them. So obvious, they give you an obvious one at first. There's the boy at the front, teaching all the old people. And then, my radio's going for it up there. And then we got a Phil Collins lookalike with a bit of bald down there. And you can see him just over to the side here. So it's really fun. It's a really fun idea, I think. Really cool Inner Sleeves. I really like this. And then here's the second one. Got a guy reading a comic. Who, of course, he's pretty easy because he's right at the back reading his comic. We got this bloke here. Well, I'm pretty sure it's this guy, but he's got his arm out on the cover, so I think they might have messed up on that one. And yeah, we've got these three here. Well, I'm pretty sure are these three gentlemen along here. So yeah, it's just a really, really cool cover. There's loads of little details on the actual album cover itself as well. Which is really nice. It's like there's a desk open and you can see the album cover to Definitely Maybe popped up. Why is this record sleeve not going back in? Please go back in. God's sake. What is it with some of these records? I mean, honestly. Before you say it, because I know what some of you are going to say, it's going to be like, take the shrink off. The shrink's fine. It's not baggy. That's not stopping it. Yeah, you can see Definitely Maybe just down there, which is pretty cool, I think. So yeah, that is what I like to say the classic Oasis albums there. You know, their first three albums, and then this was a nice little follow-up to them three. And then this is when Oasis took a turn, of course. They changed a bit. They come out with this album here, Standing on the Shoulders of Giants. And I personally believe this is Oasis' weakest album. Yeah, it's a very interesting album. It opens up with a track called Fucking in the Bushes, which is absolutely beautifully titled. Who Feels Love? I like that song, that was good. Gas Panic's pretty good. I Can See a Liar, I don't mind that track. Bit weird. This is one of my favourite albums. I love the cover. Love the cover. You can tell how big their egos were at this point with the title of the album. And yeah, it has some little inner bits, which is nice. So you get this insert. And you get an inner sleeve, which is nice. And voila, le record. So yeah. Standing on the Shoulders of Giants. I don't dislike this album. It's still a good album. Some people are way too harsh on it. Some people act like it's the worst thing on the planet. And it is definitely not that. But I think it is Oasis' weakest album. It's the one I've got the least enjoyment out of. So moving on to the next album is an album which maybe gets too much love, I think. Because people act like this is a fantastic comeback for Oasis. And it is a good comeback, it really is. But out of their later albums, it's not their best album. As I think the one that follows it is better. But here we have Heathen Chemistry, which is a good album. I really do like this album. Hindu Times, the opening track, is bandabidozy. It's one of the best tracks Oasis have put out. There's some other really good songs on here called Hung in a Bad Place, Songbirds, A Quick Peep, She Is Love. Better Man, really good song as well. So yeah, very, very weird looking album cover. I think they're on the London Underground there, I believe. Looks like it, waiting for a train maybe, or in a tunnel, I think. Well, we got some inner sleeves in here, which is nice. So I believe these are just taken from the recording sessions of the album. And then it's like blue on that side. Come on, there's download codes in here and they keep getting stuck on them. Oh, this is nice. This is very nice, actually. Really nice picture of the band. Really like that one. And then in this one, we've got Red Again and Yellow. And then you also get a book, which is quite nice. X-ray vision of something, maybe some, I don't know what that is. It's gonna say someone's teeth. So yeah, you open it up. There he is, look at him. From the Grimsby Brothers himself. Really nice that they chucked this in. Very nice. I do remember this now that I'm looking at it. Really nice picture here. Really like that one. That is beautiful. I don't know where that is. Is that London on the Thames? I don't know. Might be London on the Thames, or maybe Paris, by the looks of it. Yeah. So yeah, Heathen Chemistry. Good album. Really enjoy it. But a lot of people say this is the best of the later Oasis. I think the next album is really, really good Oasis. The next album up is among their best work. It's up there with their first three albums. this is Don't Believe the Truth. I hate the cover, I'm not going to lie. It's very off-putting. Yeah, this album has so many good songs. Turn Up the Sun is a fantastic opener. Probably even better than the Hindu Times. Lila is fantastic. Love Like a Bomb is fantastic. The Importance of Being Idle is one of Oasis' best songs ever. The Meaning of Soul is great. Keep the Dream Alive is great. And I love Let There Be Love because Liam and Noel, you know, they kind of take it in turns to sing a verse each and it just works so well. It's beautiful. And yeah, just no book with this one, just an inner sleeve. See, that should have been the cover. That should have been the cover. And then, yeah, you just got, I think they're the lyrics. Yeah. So yeah, love this album. As I say, if you're kind of lukewarm on Oasis and only have the first three albums and wondering if you want to even try their later ones, try this one. This is a solid album. I really, really enjoy this album. It's such a fun time. And as I say, The Importance of Being Idle is one of my all-time favourite Oasis slash Noel Gallagher songs. And then of course here we have the last Oasis album, Dig Out Your Soul, which I also really like. Some people are quite harsh on this one as well. I'd still take this over Standing on the Shoulders of Giants any day. The opening track, Back It Up, is incredible. Really, really good opening song. The rest of the album, I don't really have any standouts, but I think it flows pretty well. It's an interesting listen. I had to order this album all the way from America, because here in the UK, they just don't sell it anymore. It's quite a rare item here in the UK, even the reissue. Inner sleeve, brilliant. Probably the best inner sleeves yet. We got the band. Very nice. Very, very nice. So yeah, I really enjoy this album. It's gotten forgotten, that's for sure. It's the one Oasis album which never gets talked about. So I always see people posting like any of the records I've shown so far, but never this one. This one gets no attention. Which is a real shame. But anyway, we're going to do Liam Gallagher solo first. So first thing Liam Gallagher did was BDI. So this is BDI's first album. This is called Different Gear Still Speeding. Favourite tracks on here is The Roller and Beatles and Stone. Which is pretty cool because they follow one another on this album. So you get the two best songs back to back, I think. But yeah, there's some really other good tracks on here. It's a really good rocking Liam Gallagher album. Very enjoyable. It's not amazing, don't get me wrong, but I really do enjoy this album whenever it goes on. Yeah, so I can hear the budgie going, the dogs going for food. Yeah, you got some nice inner sleeves with this one as well. I'm not a big fan of the cover. I like the back cover more. Again, that should have been the cover. So yeah, for those of you who didn't know, who are watching this video purely to get to know these two brilliant musicians, Liam and Noel Gallagher, this is Liam Gallagher's second band after the split of Oasis. Liam Gallagher wanted to stay in a band, so he did. This was his second band, BDI. Obviously not quite to the standards of Oasis, but still a very good attempt at a band. However, their second album, which is getting very hard to find, get it quickly because this one's going to get very rare. This one's just simply called B. I did not really like this album. It's the only album here that I have today where I can say I'm not a big fan of it. And I apologise to people who do like it because it is still Liam Gallagher at the end of the day rocking out and it's, you know, there's enjoyable moments on it. But yeah, I'm just not a fan of the music on this album. Yeah, it's a naked woman on the cover. If you want to see her in all her glory. There she is, the nipple. You can see a nipple. Oh my God, YouTube hates me. Yeah. So it's a very weird cover. I'm not sure who that is on the cover, but I respect her. I'm only kidding. So yeah, it's a nice big thick album. And I don't think you get anything with this one. I'm just trying to look in. Oh no, I'm pretty sure you do actually. I think you get a poster. So if you want the boob even larger, you can do this. Oh no, there are orange sleeves. There are orange sleeves. My bad. My apologies. B, lyrics. I can hear my radio messing up upstairs, Jesus. Okay. There's the band. And, yeah, you get poster, and I'm pretty sure it is just, yes, giant boobie. B. So yeah, why this ain't on my wall, I don't know. I need to put that on my wall. I'm only kidding. I made a funny. Right, go back in. Go back in. And that's it for BDI. Only two albums. Why, I don't know. I really don't know why they split. I don't know. There might be some news out there. All of a sudden it just got announced. It wasn't even a year ago. It was, you know, about 7 or 8 months ago, Liam Gallagher's doing a debut solo album. And here it is, As You Were. Don't really like the cover, I don't really like the artwork in general for this album. It's very plain, very, very boring. But when I got this album, I was very meh on it. But I really like it now, it's really grown on me, it's a really good album. It's not amazing, but it is pretty damn solid. The opening track, World of Glass, is one of Liam Gallagher's best ever rockers. There's no question about that in my mind. I also love Bold, Greedy Soul, Paper Crown. For What It's Worth is a fantastic Oasis feeling song. And When I'm in Need is a really good song as well. And then the B-side is pretty much all average, I think. That's where the album falls flat. It's like the B-side, I couldn't really get into nearly any of it. Really nice picture of Liam there. Because he's such a good performer, isn't he? He just stands with his hands behind his back and just sings up like that. Don't even talk to the audience, don't you? Dog's crying now. I'll be out in a minute, mate. Just finish this. So yeah, Liam Gallagher, as you were. Some people were too harsh on this album. Some people were too kind on it when it came out. I really think it's a middle of the road album. Maybe a bit better than that. It's a good album. It is. It was a very controversial album, really. Because I hear a lot of both sides of the story on that one. And now we move on to Noel Gallagher, who has some masterpiece albums. So the first one up is his debut, which is self-titled. Well, Noel Gallagher and his new band, the High Flying Birds. So it's Noel Gallagher's High Flying Birds. I absolutely adore this album, guys. It's so good. This is such a solid album. I wish I was a fan when it came out, because I don't know how excited I would have been that Noel Gallagher was doing an album, because Liam Gallagher being the frontman of Oasis, but wow, what an album. Everybody's on the Run's fantastic. The Death of You and Me is possibly the best song Noel Gallagher's ever sung. Record Machine is fantastic. I can't really speak. Every song on this album is just, it is fantastic. I have taken this one out of Shrink, because the Shrink was pretty much falling off it. Such a beautiful, beautiful album. I love it so, so much. And everyone goes to Noel's second album. That's the one that gets all the love. Don't get me wrong, Noel's second album is like so close behind this one for me. I love them just as much, really. But this album, I think, is just that touch better. It's just so good and it's just fantastic. Oh, hello, you've come in here now, have you? Hmm? Here she comes. What are you doing? Hey, what are you doing? Look at this. You're on YouTube. That's it. What's that? Hey, camera. camera back. So here is the second album, of course, which we just talked about. This is called Noel Gallagher's High Flying Birds, Chasing Yesterday. This has Noel's best single ever on in the heat of the moment. Also has some other fantastic songs like The Ballad of Mighty Eye. Fantastic record as well. Absolutely fantastic. And then I also bought this. This is a remix album of some of the tracks on there. It's a double LP set, non-gatefold though, very cheaply made. Pretty sure they're in plain white, inner sleeves as well. I'm not too sure. But, yeah, I'm trying to go a bit quicker now because I can see the video's got very long. Yes, here she goes. So we've got The Ballad of Mighty Eye, The Heat in a Moment, Riverman, The Right Stuff. The Girl with the X-Ray Eyes. And In the Heat of the Moment, we've got remixes of all them. There's a couple remixes of some of them, though. Some of them, there's like two or three different ones. And I'm not going to lie, I still don't know what this is, but I bought it anyway because it was cheap. This is a 12-inch single for El Mexicano, The Reflex. I don't know what this is, but as you can see, it is Noel Gallagher related. Maybe someone can let me know in the comments, because I own it, and I wouldn't mind knowing what it is. And of course we have Noel's third and, at the minute, final album, but I'm sure there'll be another one soon enough. Who Built the Moon? Love the cover. Fantastic cover. Yeah, not as good as his first two, that's for sure. It was kind of disappointing at first, because it was like his first two, for me, are pretty much masterpieces. I love them. And this one isn't quite there, but it's still a very, very, very good, very solid album. Fort Knox is a great opener. Holy Mountain is an incredible song, incredible single. It's a Beautiful World is also really good. Black and White Sunshine I like. And the title track, The Man Who Built the Moon, is also really good. And then the very last record up I have to show is this. This is the 12-inch single to Holy Mountain. Yeah. And then you also get Holy Mountain Instrumental and Dead in the Water. Live, which is pretty cool. I haven't opened it because I didn't really see the need to for the collection. Again, This weren't HMV actually, but the sticker just looks like a HMV one. So yeah, that is my Oasis collection, guys. I hope you've enjoyed it. There's quite a lot here, as you can see. This is everything that Liam and Noel have put out up to this date. Of course, if you're watching in the future, maybe 2019, I reckon there'll be another one from one of them, I'm sure. But yeah, the reason I'm missing it is because it hasn't come out yet. But I hope you've enjoyed this video, guys. Please hit that subscribe button, like the video, leave a message, and I'll see you guys next time for another video.